Welcome to this tutorial. If you are to reskin Killing Floor, you need the game Killing Floor and have it installed. And if you have the game Killing Floor, then you'll also get with it if you go to Library Tools. And if you scroll down, you'll see Killing Floor SDK. And initially it'll be not installed, so you just have to run it, install it, and then you'll be able to run the Killing Floor editor. Another program that you'll probably need is a editing software. I use Adobe Photoshop, but there are free options out there. For example, paint.net, www.getpaint.net. There's also gimp.org. Those are a couple free alternatives, but whatever version you have to get a DDS plugin. So you can see DDS plugin for GIMP, for Photoshop CC, CS6, or maybe paint.net. So just do a Google search and be sure to get that plugin so you can actually open up the programs that you find. Anyway, when you open Killing Floor SDK for the first time, you will see this ugly looking red gore thing. This is actually what we'll use most of the time, the textures, the texture browser. If for some reason you close out of it and you don't know how to get it back, you'll find it under View and show texture browser right there. And it should pop it right back up. It's active class and all these other cool things. But textures is the one we're going to use the most, so I'm just going to make it big. So how you navigate this texture browser, you can navigate through the packages either by clicking on the upper scroll wheel here. And what I found out, it doesn't actually show all the files that you can open. Like, it doesn't have any of my custom stuff on there. Or you can just go File, Open, and manually select your file. Like, I got my Nobletron skin packs here. And these are considered groups. So I have all my first person skins grouped together. I also have third person groups. And I also have a portrait section. Anyway, what you want to do is find the skin you're going to be editing. So once you find the texture that you want, you'll see there's usually three or four different versions of it. And what you want is the one that starts with the word texture and ends with DXT. 3 or DXT5 or any DXT compressions. It really doesn't matter. And there's a couple ways to extract it. You can right click, go to export to file, or you can just go to file, export when you have it selected. And then you can choose where to export it. I'm just going to export to the desktop. I'm just going to call this Indy, because I'm just going to change this guy to Indiana Jones. Then save it in there. So now that I have it, time for me to edit it. So I go over to my editor, tell it to open the DDS file, desktop, there's my Indy folder. There we go. And you can open that. And you see the skin, and basically you just do what you normally do in an editor here. Skip over to once I finish editing. Okay, so once we've changed all that, usually you go to File, Save As, and let's go back to the Indy folder. And you don't really want to save it as PSD. Well, I guess you could, but this is the important part, the DDS. And let's just save over it. Yep. And then when you export it, you want a DXT5 or DXT3. Doesn't really matter which one, but they both have the explicit alpha. There we are. We've done it. So now we head back over to the SDK. And we want to go to import. We want to import this one. Now when we tell it to import, be sure to choose a different package name because we don't want it to replace our original. So let's just call it the package name indie. Group, third person, name. You can name it whatever you want. You can just call it Indiana. Okay. That looks good. So now, what I would normally do is probably save right now. Just name it. This will be your package name, .utx. Click save. So, it is possible to just go running around like this, but you won't get all the fancy details. So, in order to get those details, I usually create a new combiner. So, change the material class from shader to combiner. And as for the name, I usually name it exactly the same as my texture, only add a CMB to show that's combiner and EMV to show it's my environmental combiner. So now that I have it over here, change the combine operation over to alpha blend with modulation. As for material 1, what you can do is you can click on the none and make sure you select the texture. And then you just click use and it'll automatically type everything out for you. So I don't have to type nd.3p.indiana. Just by typing use, get that on there. As for material 2, there's this one reflection that I believe almost everything in Killing Floor uses. And I have it down here in my tutorial. So copy that, go back, and paste that in. And just click out of it, and it should create this little fancy oil effect. Now we want to create another one. This one is another combiner, and this time we'll just call it CMB, not the EMV after that. So this time the combine operation will be with the mask. So material 1 will be the texture, and texture will also be the material for the mask. Now material 2, make sure you select the environment and click use. After that, click save, or else you won't be able to. Yes, I want to replace it. Okay, now the only thing that's left is actually using the skin. So I will go over to the system. Go to system and find your characters.upl. So are those Harkiers, Beginton, and then you edit it with your favorite text program. And usually this is all one line. And so within that line you want to find body skin. Body skin equals, then you want to direct this to your package. So our package was indie and third person Indiana CMB. And then you click save. So I will just demonstrate for you real quick. And I guess I forgot to mention, if you try reskinning weapons, you have to actually create a mutator to run it, or else you won't be able to join multiplayer games. Ice Cave. Ice Cave's bright enough. Alrighty, let's go choose this wonderful character right here. Our Indiana Jones dude. Maybe I should change the gloves so they're brown too. Anyway, so when you play it. You can see this is our Indiana skin. Okay, and that's it. Thanks for watching.